a presentation of AIT.
Miss Eisenberg.
I don't see how this glorified cooler is going to help me get a date to the dance.
Trust me, once the girls see this awesome fog, they won't be able to resist you.
They've never had trouble before. How is this thing gonna make fog?
All we have to do is put the dry ice in the water and turn on the fan just before Tiffany makes her big entrance.
Queen of the morning dew. Leave it to Tiffany to get the lead in the first place she tries out for.
When you've got it, you've got it.
Oh, hi, Tiff. We were just talking about you.
So I hear. I did come check on you two. Miss Heisenberg was uncertain whether you could get the fog machine to work.
Oh, I think we've got it covered.
Don't mess up my big entrance. Remember my promise.
You wouldn't really tie me in a pretzel not leaving the gym locker for the wrestling team, would you?
Just don't mess with the queen of the morning dew.
Hustle up, guys. Miss Heisenberg is ready for rehearsal. Places, everyone. That means you, Your Highness.
Hey, Marty, where's the dry ice?
It came in this morning. I put it over there.
Okay, Tiffany enters at the beginning. Better go ahead and put in the dry ice.
What's wrong?
It's gone.
What do you mean, gone? We're dead.
I'm gonna spend my formative years as a pretzel in a gym locker.
From field and mountain, from the depths of the sea, I call forth the mist of the earth to cover thee. I call forth the mist of the earth to cover thee.
Sean, what are you gonna do? I'm as good as a pretzel already.
Where is my fog? It disappeared. What do you mean it disappeared?
I told you, I think someone
stole it. It's okay, somebody stole it.
I can't hear when it's finished.
When what's finished?
The karma.
What brings you guys to my garage of scientific fun this time?
Queen of the morning dew lost her mist, and now she's gonna turn me into a pretzel.
What?
The queen of the morning dew is Tiffany's character in this year's school play, The Maid of the Mist.
You are the queen of the morning dew?
Yeah, but I'm not much of a queen without my dew. These two need you to help them make my mist.
Cirella, Sean and I operate the dry ice machine for the play.
The dry ice was in this cooler in the morning, and by rehearsal time, it had disappeared.
You want to find out where it went?
Yeah.
Well, we'll have to duplicate the entire painful incident.
We'd figured you'd say something like that, so we brought the cooler.
Am I that predictable?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, listen, we'll keep the lid on it. We'll take a look at it later. Now, what do you mind readers think happened to the dry ice?
These knuckleheads lost it.
No way. I think somebody stole it.
Nobody stole it. Maybe it just went away.
Mm. Things don't just go away.
But there's nothing in the cooler.
This gets more interesting by the minute. Now, how can we find out what happened when the dry ice disappeared?
Well, we could watch the dry ice over a period of time and see what happens to it.
We could put a piece of dry ice in a beaker and see if it disappears on its end. Yeah.
Sounds good.
Where are we going to get dry ice?
I have some in my ice cream cooler.
Mm.
It disappeared.
Well, we know someone didn't steal it.
Where did it go?
It melted.
But why wasn't there any water left behind?
That's a good question. Now, how can we measure exactly what happens when the dry ice disappears?
We could take the temperature of the dry ice as it's going away.
Yeah, and we could weigh it, you know, to see if weight changes.
How about if we put it in a sealed container and see if it gives off anything?
Now, we'd need something to compare the dry ice with.
We could use some ice cubes from the freezer.
Hold it. Isn't that the same thing we had before?
Yeah.
Well, what happened?
The flask with the dry ice is empty, but the flask with the ice has water in the bottom of it.
Huh. The weight didn't change, so something must still be in there.
Maybe the dry ice only looks different.
Yeah, but how come the balloon over the water ice didn't fill up?
I don't know, but that dry ice was a lot colder than the ice cubes from the freezer.
Dry ice isn't anything like regular ice.
What makes you say that?
Well, the dry ice and the water ice don't act the same.
Yeah, I'll say. The balloon over that dry ice filled up with something, but the balloon over the water ice just sitting there like it did when we started.
Well, what could we do to make the water balloon fill up?
We could pump air into it.
How are we gonna do that?
What if we boil the water?
What if we boil the water?
And there it goes.
What's filling the balloon?
Steam.
Well, do you think steam is in the other balloon?
Well, let's see what happens as we add heat to the dry ice balloon.
It's getting bigger.
Hey, look, you guys, the water from the water balloon is coming back.
And the balloon's getting smaller.
Why doesn't anything from the dry ice come back?
This dry ice is weird stuff. What is it?
Well, we know it isn't water, but what is it?
It doesn't melt like water. What is it?
Yeah, what is
Whoa,
it?
Whoa, slow down. You know, I think my bowling partner might be able to help you guys.
Bowling partner? Rollo?
Yeah. Yeah.
This place is cool.
Hey, they don't call it Stan's Ice Palace for nothing. What can I help you kids with?
Well, Steve Rolowinski sent us to meet with his bowling partner.
Some guy named Stan?
Rollo said you might come over. I'm Stan. Now, what can I do for you?
Well, Mr. Stan, we wanted to find out about dry ice.
You certainly came to the right place. Hey, forget about that Mr. Stan stuff. For friends of Rollo's, it's just plain Stan.
Okay.
We had some dry ice that mysteriously disappeared.
Actually, we think it melted, and we want to know why there wasn't any water left behind.
Oh, that's simple. Follow me.
This is where dry ice comes from?
Yep.
Hey, look, you guys, this is the dry ice is really solidified carbon dioxide.
I knew it wasn't water.
It's cold over here.
It says that it's minus 109 degrees Fahrenheit.
That is cold.
How do you make it?
Well, I pipe in the liquid carbon dioxide, I put it in that chamber there, and cool it to minus 109 degrees Fahrenheit, and the machine stamps it out as dry ice nuggets. Hey, slow down, little buddy. That frozen carbon dioxide is a little too cold to touch.
I thought you used liquid carbon dioxide.
Sure do.
I don't see any liquid.
Mm-mm. Well, follow me. Now, it's going to be real noisy in there, so you're going to have to cover your ears. Okay. Now, what were you saying, little lady?
I said it looks just like water.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
How could I see the liquid carbon dioxide in a tube, but I couldn't see it out here?
Well, I saw a pressure gauge in there, so I guess it must be under some sort of pressure.
And the temperature gauge was at minus 56 degrees Fahrenheit. Hey,
what would happen if we pour the liquid out of the tank?
This.
It would hiss?
It becomes a gas.
So that's what happened to the dry ice. It became a gas.
The gas filled the balloon.
But what makes it change?
It must have to do with the temperature and the pressure.
You mean as the temperature or pressure changes, the carbon dioxide turns into a gas?
Or a solid or a liquid. It depends on what combination of pressure and temperature you have. CO2 can be pretty slippery stuff.
Come on, let's go tell Rollo what we found.
Yeah, thanks, Mr. Stan. I mean, Stan.
All right, so long, kids. Hey, feel free to skate on back to Stan's Ice Palace any old time.
Cool, Proton Avenger. Hey, Rollo, we found out about carbon dioxide.
Yeah.
It can be a liquid, but you have to keep it under the right temperature and under the right pressure.
Well, did you find out where the dry ice went? What made the balloon expand?
It turned from a solid to a gas, and the gas filled the balloon.
How can we prove that?
Well, we would have to prove that carbon dioxide was in the balloon.
How could we test for carbon dioxide?
Well, can you use what you found out about it so far?
Well, it's a solid when it's very cold, and it's a liquid under extreme pressure.
I don't think that's very helpful.
Well, let's look at some other characteristics of carbon dioxide. How can you use these to determine what's in the balloon?
Well, we could put it on a plant and see if it grows.
That would take a while.
Yeah.
It puts out fires. What if we poured it over a match?
How can you pour carbon dioxide gas?
It says it's heavier than air.
Yeah, can we try it?
Sure.
And put it out.
If CO2 is heavier than air, maybe it's still in the cooler.
Could be. Light the candles again.
So the carbon dioxide was in the cooler all along. It just turned into a gas.
Right. Let me show you something.
What is that?
That's how our experiment looked.
Yeah, but what are all those vibrating dots?
Are those the molecules of the ice and the dry ice?
You got it.
This must be when they were solid.
Now watch what happens as they absorb heat.
Wow, the molecules in the dry ice container are moving all over the place.
The water molecules are sort of sloshing around.
Is that the difference between what gas molecules and water molecules look like?
When water's liquid.
Now, what would happen if we add heat to the water molecules?
They'll begin to move faster.
When you add heat to the water, the molecules move away from each other and fill the balloon.
Mm-hmm. As you add heat to the dry ice balloon, the carbon dioxide molecules move faster and the balloon gets bigger.
What happens if you keep adding heat?
Yeah, would the balloon keep expanding?
Well, what if you increased the pressure and wouldn't allow it to expand?
The molecules would just move faster and faster and bump into each other more often.
Man, those molecules are moving all over the place.
They're just a blur.
You know, if you keep adding heat and increasing the pressure, you might just find the fourth state of matter.
There's a fourth state of matter?
Yeah, it's called plasma.
Where would you find plasma?
It's in blood.
Is that right?
Well, it is, but I'm talking about a different kind of plasma.
Is that what plasma looks like? Mm-hmm.
What if you kept freezing the molecules and lowering the temperature?
Well, that's called supercooling.
Supercooling? How would that look? If both flasks are at the same temperature, why is the water a solid in one and a liquid in the other?
Well, there's more to states of matter than just temperature and pressure. You guys have opened up a whole new area to discover.
I don't think we've got the time to get into it. I hear the mist calling for its queen.
Oh, the play, I almost forgot. We better go, or Miss Heisenberg will be angry.
I'd better call Stan and get him to deliver some more dry ice for tonight.
Yeah, but this time, tell him to bring it a little closer to the start of the play, and we'll keep a lid on this stuff. Gotta keep that heat out.
Break a leg, Your Highness.
What about me?
Just try to stay out of gym lockers, would you?
Okay.
From field and mountain, from the depths of the sea, I call forth the mist of the earth to cover thee.
Here are some questions for further discussion. What happened to the dry ice before the dress rehearsal? What determines how fast dry ice evaporates under normal room temperature? How could you alter the process? When the kids traveled to my buddy Stan's ice palace, they found that dry ice is solidified carbon dioxide, cooled to minus 109 degrees Fahrenheit. Why should you avoid touching dry ice with your bare hands? When the kids added heat to the flask of carbon dioxide gas, the balloon expanded. If they took the same gas and kept adding heat and increasing the pressure, they would find the fourth state of matter. What is a plasma? Where do plasmas exist? By carefully lowering the temperature, you won't find another state of matter, but you will discover supercooling. How can water at the same temperature be a liquid in one container and a solid in the other? What are some possible uses for supercooling? How do materials behave differently if supercooled? Enjoy your exploration of states of matter, and remember to keep your minds on science.
To obtain a copy of the Minds on Science Teacher's Guide, contact your ITV service agency or send $7.50 check or money order to AIT Department Minds on Science, Bloomington, Indiana, 47402-0120.